kitchen. E la prima cosa che dovrò fare, la first thing that we need to do is to prendere il fardale. And I have this beautiful fardale, full of beautiful colors, just like we all are. God created us all to be magnificent and to shine our beautiful colors. And I have such an amazing, delicious, summer, easy peasy dish for you. Here in Florida, it's summer, and with summer comes mosquitoes and the beach. That's the part, and also comes with a lot of delicious fruit. And what I have here is I have this beautiful swordfish, and I am going to be grilling the swordfish with what is called stone fruit. And what are stone fruit? Stone fruit are nectarines, are peaches, and that's what I have here. I'm also going to be utilizing one green onion that I'm going to show you how I'm going to do that. I also have taken a sweet potato, and that's because I want to have sweet potato with this dish. And I have already put it in the microwave oven for about a minute or two so it gets nice and soft, and I have sliced it. So that's what I have here. But I want to walk you through the whole entire enchilada. We're not making enchilada, but we are making some wonderful grill. So get yourself a nice grill pan, because it's too hot for me to grill outside. We're going to be grilling inside. I want to say hello to all of you beautiful people. We are live. Hello, Cola. I think I see Nick. I see all these beautiful people. Thank you so much for joining. So what I want to do is I want to start marinating my fish. I like to have flavor with everything. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over my ingredients. For my marinated fish, I have 3 tablespoons of olive oil, 3 tablespoons of balsamic vinegar, and 2 tablespoons of honey. And that's what I am going to be utilizing for this. So I have my honey right here that I'm going to do right now, because you know the fruit has its own sweetness, and I'm not going to add honey to my vegetables that I'm going to grill. But I am going to add it, the honey, to, yes, the swordfish. I know, guys. You guys are going, what? Yes, I know, but just don't stress. It'll be fine. Don't worry about it. And now what I have here is my olive oil, my 3 tablespoons of olive oil. What I did is I took 2 pieces of swordfish, and because swordfish is so thick, I kind of cut them in half, so it makes it a lot easier for the grilling. Now I got my olive oil in here, and then here goes my wonderful balsamic vinegar. And that's what's going to go right in here, guys. Very easy transaction. And then I am just going to take a little shiffly like that, because I kind of want my wonderful balsamic to incorporate with the olive oil. And you're going to notice that it's going to start getting thick. See, it's getting thicker. And then what I want to do is I just want to take my fish, and I'm just going to put it right in here, because as this is doing its thing, guys, okay? And I'm just going to take this down. I'm over with that. What happens now is that this is all going to marinate each other in here while we are working on the other. And wait till I show you what we're going to do with the other. So what I want to do is I want to incorporate. And it did, you know, when you're using 2 pieces and you slice them, now if you're going to be using more, depending on the size of your family, then I would implore you to use more, you know, to just, instead of 3 tablespoons of olive oil, maybe use 4 or 5, and then, you know, instead of 3 tablespoons of balsamic, maybe use more, and so is the honey. So I'm done with that. That is all finito, finished with that. Put that on the side. So what I want to do now is, okay, I'm done with this. I'm going to move this out of the side. And then what I want to do now is, when you cut your fruit, let me bring this to you so I can show this to you. When you cut your fruit, okay, you know, it's really hard to take the pit out. So I don't mess around with that. What I do is I take my peach or my apple, and I just lay it down like so, and I'm just going to get the bigger part of that, just like that, easy peasy. And then what I do to the sides is I'm going to take the sides, because you know the sides are good, and then I chop this up and give it to the birds. Yes, I do feed the birds. Well, you know, I mean, it's we gotta help Mother Nature, especially when we're taking so much of their homes. And then what I do with this, what I do with the rest of the fruit is I'm gonna put it all in here, because what I do is I just chop it up. Because that's going to give us, oh, wait till I show you, this is going to be so delicious. This is Elena style. Okay, so now that I have the fruit that I have in here, and that's what I used here, I'm using peaches, nectarines, green onion, I do have 4 little cherry tomatoes, and then I also have my sweet potatoes. Okay, so let me just move this out of the way, because I want to stick with the fruit. Okay, to this fruit, what we have here is I have taken a tablespoon of olive oil, a tablespoon of balsamic vinegar, and I've also taken the honey, yes. And then I am going to add a tablespoon of wonderful cilantro. I love cilantro with this. It just gives it such a nice flavor, and you're just gonna mix all this together like so. Okay, so far so good. All right, so then what I'm gonna do now is I am going to take this and I'm just gonna put it into the fruit, not the one that I am going to be grilling. This is what's gonna go on top of our fish. Yes. All right, so now I'm done with that. That is as simple and fast as entire transaction goes. And then now what we're gonna do is just we're going to mix this together like that. Look at this, and you got all these beautifulness, the same things, you know, that's going to be so delicious. So it's going to kind of mimic the fish, but this is going to be on top. All right, so now I'm done with that. Remember, we have this, the marinated wonderful swordfish that you never thought about adding honey to, and then the fruit that we use. Now I have another bowl right here. So this is what we are going to brush all of these wonderful things that we are going to grill. And let me tell you what I have here. I have a teaspoon of paprika, which is actually mine is smoked paprika. A teaspoon of chipotle pepper because I like the smokiness. A teaspoon of garlic powder, and that's what's going to go right in here like so. Let me get all this in here like that. Done, we're done with that. And then what I have here is 2 tablespoons of olive oil and also 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. Yes, 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. And then we're just going to shiffly this thing like this. It's going to turn like a very pretty color. Look at this very pretty color. And then what we are going to do now is we are going to bring our wonderful fruits, and also, you know, tomatoes were thought to be, they're not real vegetables, they are fruit. So that's why I am going to implement them. So what I want to do now is I want to take my brush and I want to brush my apple. And I'm going to lay it down, and I have a cast iron skillet with ridges. And that's what I'm going to do. Just going to lay it down like so. I'm going to do the same thing with my peach. And what I usually do is I do 1 peach per person. I love peaches. It could be more if you want more. But it's my husband and I, and that's what we are going to do. We're going to do 1 peach per person. And then when you lay them down, don't touch them. What I have done is I oiled, you know, I always tell you to keep your cast iron skillets well, you know, I call them oiled, seasoned. So now I'm going to get my nectarines, and they're going to go right in here like so. This is such a lovely dish. You can also do this on the grill outside, but this girl is not grilling outside. No, 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 no. Especially, you know, I'm still having my hot flashes, eh? And everything I'm doing is natural with lots of lavender oil. All right, so while these guys are doing their thing, I am going to get the same thing going on with my potatoes here, my sweet potatoes. They all are going to get this beautiful, and it makes such a nice glaze. It just does this wonderful thing that happens in the grill. And as you can see, I am doing quite a few of the sweet potatoes. Sweet potatoes are very high in nutrients for us. And I'm going to tell you something else. You know, swordfish, it's wonderful because it's low in fats. It's lean protein, And it's got all these wonderful, wonderful things. And then what you want to do is you want to just kind of get these little tomatoes. I'm going to do the tomatoes last because the tomatoes have a lot of juice. So I don't want these tomatoes to be all juicy because I don't want everything to get super juicy. So again, you know, whatever I have left over, I'm going to be utilizing. So then now, as we are doing this, let me just rinse my hands real quick. Oh yeah, this is rocking and rolling. Get yourself a nice little platter like so, because these guys are almost done. And what I do is I have them here on medium. Oh yes, they're starting, oh yes, oh they look so pretty. You know, I'm not a professional chef, but I am a food influencer. Somebody said, you're a food influencer. I kind of like that, food influencer. So now, you know, they're getting all these nice little ridges, and oh my goodness, they look so delicious. And everything I'm using is organic. Anything soft skin, guys, spend the money to buy organic. You can buy organic. There's a lot of places you can buy organic, and it's not that it's expensive as you think it is. So right now, I'm just turning them around. I have raised my temperature. And I'm not looking for perfect grill marks, okay? Nothing has to be perfect, because when you want to make it perfect, it causes a lot of stress, and I'm not going to stress over this deliciousness. Why should I stress? Okay, so then now I can take these out, and I like mine crocante. You know, crocante means crunchy, and I'm just going to put all this beautifulness right on my platter. As I do that, I am going to go ahead and move my potatoes in. Oh, yes. Because now these guys, oh, yes. And it's so delicious. You know, when you do put them on a smoker or on a grill, it's delicious. But when you don't want to do that because it's too hot, then you can do something like this indoors. And trust me, for me, I like indoors when it's this hot. Unless, you know, I am somewhere where there's a beach and a pool. Who doesn't want to be at the beach and the pool? So what I'm doing right now is I am just getting all of these cute little guys in here. Oh, it's looking marvelous and beautiful. You know, and if you're having somebody over, this makes such a nice presentation. And it's so pretty. So now I'm doing my sweet potatoes. And now, as you can see how fast and easy everything goes. So what I want to tell you guys is, you know, the swordfish. You know, swordfish is loaded in zinc. Swordfish is omega-3 acids, and it has psyllium. And the good thing is it's low in fat. So, you know, I mean, why not have this wonderful fish, and right now it's in season. I don't know if you can catch it in season. I'm not a fisher person, but I know that I was easily able to find it at the stores. So then we have this beautifulness over here. And then what I want to do to the beautifulness is, because, you know, we're going to be utilizing some of this wonderful, and you can use parsley if you don't want to add cilantro. You're more than welcome to do that. But I think that cilantro with fruit, with this, and that's what I'm doing. I'm just kind of putting it on top of here. I am going to turn my wonderful potatoes now over. That's why it's good, guys, to get your potatoes cooked ahead of time. You know, and for those moms that work, you know, if you prep the night before, it's going to make your life so much easier. You know, I kind of wish I knew that when I was younger, because I would work, you know, 40 to 45 hours a week, and I would come home, and, you know, and I would be so tired as a single mom, and sometimes I did not know what to do. So what I'm doing is I'm just taking some of the leaves, guys, just for decoration on my vegetables, on my wonderful vegetables. Well, a fruit. Fruit. You see what I'm doing right here? Now my potatoes are almost there. Just a few more minutes. I'm gonna move these guys out of the way because now I can go ahead and bring my wonderful, remember that we've been marinating this beautiful fish, this wonderful, wonderful, delicious swordfish. Just gonna put it down in there. Now I'm finished with my sweet potatoes and I'm just gonna put them on my side because my sweet potatoes are you know what I'm just doing? I'm just putting the marks on them because they're cooked. They're practically all cooked. And I had just taken them out of the microwave. And then I sliced them. And this is how to prep and make your life a lot easier, guys. Because what I like to do is I like to bring you healthy, delicious, easy meals, especially during the summertime. So what I'm doing now is I am putting my wonderful, oh yes, look at that. Woo! So wonderful. Ah, yes, and I'm going to continue to remove my, oh, and see, they still have the grill marks. They still have the grill marks. Okay, and I'm done with that. The tomatoes, you know, they are just doing their thing. Now they're starting to kind of get juicier. They're hanging out there. The fish is right next to it. And I'm all, you can smell everything on the fish. You can just, oh, it looks so wonderful. Oh my goodness gracious. Yes, yes, yes. I'm gonna turn this up a little bit higher because I wanna show you the end results to this. It doesn't take much for fish, and especially if you cut it in half, it cuts your time in half. And remember, when you start prepping the night before, it makes your life a lot easier the next day. And that's what I did, except for the sweet potato. What I did with the sweet potato, I left the skin and everything because it's all organic. I washed it very well. I pinched it. I put it in the microwave oven for about 1 or 2 minutes. And that's what I did. And this is almost there, guys. It's almost there. Now we got to, the fish cooks really quick. And especially, you know, when you have it on a medium high, like I do here, and it's having all this wonderful juice, and it's really quick how this, it comes together. And then it's almost there because I want to make sure that my fish is cooked. In the meantime, my potatoes are done because they were almost done. And all you're doing is just, you know, you're just putting the little grill, I don't know if you can see, the grill marks. And it's such a nice tasty dish because what you're doing with this is you're utilizing the entire fruit. And then that's what I do when you just slice it on the sides and you still have the pit, because when I did it with the apple, it still has the pit. So you can take the rest of what's around it and you can make it into this beautiful salsa that is not a salsa, because it's really not a salsa. It's what I do because, you know, I don't like throwing anything away. And my family will never throw anything away. Oh, yes, look at this. So now my fish is done, and I'm just going to add it like so. That is how quick this came. My husband, he just came out of his office. My tomatoes are looking beautiful. Look at that. And then, you know, I'm just going to add a tomato here, a tomato there. Why not? You know, 4 little tomatoes is not going to hurt anything. That bigger guy, I'm just going to shut him off. He's going to stay in there. Because then what I want to do now is I want to come and get this beautiful stuff. And I just want to add it right on top of here. Yes. Because I want to serve this deliciousness to go with this wonderful swordfish. And this is such a beautiful dish, guys. It's so refreshing. It's so Florida, especially when it's nice and hot. And then let me show you what you have here. Let me show you this wonderful grilled sword fish with stone grilled fruit. And of course, you know, I added the sliced sweet potatoes, and why not? And this is what you have here. I want to thank my wonderful sponsors, Carla Harris with pharmacy. I want to thank Stephen Billy with Billy Fishing and Charters. I want to thank Dario Rodriguez with Life and Food Superstores. And I want to thank my wonderful friend. I don't know if you can see my nails over here. I've just got so much going on. I don't think you can even see my nails with Color Street. And I want to thank you for joining me in this beautiful mangiata.